So twist and shout this Teachable Tuesday. We're going to give you a twist to your rosary today.
Fun.
Hello, my name is Claire. No, my name is Todd.
And I'm Claire.
I was going to go next and say I was Claire, but I'm not. I'm Angel.
Rosary, when we pray the rosary, it's a prayer of meditation, so we're actively engaging the imagination, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So how would you normally pray? I mean, not that there's one way to pray it, but what are we doing when we're engaging our imagination in the rosary?
Well, I think I've said this before, but I'll just say it again real quick for anybody that wasn't able to tune into our prayer series a couple of weeks ago. But a lot of times adults kind of shy away from that idea of using their imagination in prayer just because they think, oh, well, like, I'm burnt out. I have no good ideas. I don't know how to use my imagination anymore. But I really want to encourage you, if you've ever had a conversation where then afterwards you replay that scene and say, oh, I wish I could have done this better. Or if you're driving in a car and someone cuts you off
never.
And you
never
have an imaginative conversation with that person that just cut you off.
Does it include gestures?
Right,
at all?
Yeah, exactly. I want to just challenge you a little bit because I think you have a pretty darn good imagination.
That's great.
We just don't oftentimes use it, especially in prayer. And we tend to freeze up and think, oh, I can't possibly do this correct, right? But with our imaginations, there's freedom, and God gave us imagination, so our imaginations can be really good, and so do not fear about, like, not knowing the technical terms of things or being historically correct, right? Our imagination is just a free space to be able to explore with God, especially in the context of the rosary.
When we invite the Holy Spirit in to oversee it, especially, right? We want a little bit of control so we don't go goofy.
Correct. Yeah, for sure.
But in that, We engage our holy imaginations. I mean, it's a gift from God, these beautiful thoughts and the brains that we're given, so that we can imagine that we're actually there. The sights,
put
the sounds.
Put yourself in the scene.
Yeah, the smells. How does the wind feel even? What's the heat like in the plant? Like, and it can become so real. What we're doing in engaging our imagination is we're literally creating, like, memories.
Yes.
We're creating touchstones that we can go back to.
I almost think, too, it's like making it be a 3D experience. Because a lot of times when we pray, we can have these, like, paintings that flash in our minds of, like, oh, I remember seeing a painting of this scene or something like that. But then that's just what it stays like. We don't really go into that moment, right? And so it's like making a 3D experience of what's happening.
Enter into
a
movie.
That's a great way to put it.
Yeah, a movie, a cinematic experience.
Instead of it being flat.
Right.
Yeah.
Really
engage
with
it. So here's the twist to your rosary. Twist and shout, right? We're not saying tangle your rosary around and twist it that way. But in your thoughts, do not only think of it from the standpoint of Jesus or Mary or maybe the other key characters, but try to pray the rosary from God the Father's point of view. What is God the Father thinking, doing, feeling? How's he actively engaged in this moment?
Right, because he's there. He's present.
For real.
Yeah.
And every one of them. Every scene.
Right.
So I've got a friend that talks about heroic fatherhood, rather.
Okay.
Heroic fatherhood. Oh my goodness, what an idea.
I love that.
What an idea to gain from the Father. What does it mean to be, you know, that kind of a loving parental figure.
Love that.
Whether you're male or female, the fatherhood or the motherhood, but seeing it from his point of view. So, for example, at the Annunciation, oh my goodness, what is God the Father thinking? He sets this in motion.
Right.
And
the mission's Gabriel.
Like, can you imagine the conversation between God and Gabriel?
Right.
Oh my gosh.
So, Gabe, I want you to go talk to this girl. This is what you're going to say.
When I prayed on that, I think of Gabriel saying, now's the time. Now? Yeah. Like, now we can do this. We can really do this. Like, the excitement.
I love that, too, in the fact that when we're engaging in this, whether it's with God the Father or maybe one of the other characters in, not even characters, but one of the other saints that are present in these mysteries, is asking them a question and seeing where your mind goes and seeing the response that the Holy Spirit inspires. That has just been something that I've been trying to do a little bit more recently. And so one of the, like, examples would be, like, finding Jesus in the temple, right? And I was in that moment and I decided I really wanted to ask Mary a question about what she was feeling, what was going on in her mind, because I was thinking about, like, anxiety, right, and how anxiety, like, when I have anxiety, there's, like, a lack of hope in my life, or maybe there's some, like, despair or a lack of trust, and I was thinking, well, that doesn't fit with the character of Mary at all,
right.
But I know that she, you know, she says after she finds Jesus, is, we've been looking for you, you know, and she has emotions, so I said, Mary, what was behind those feelings if it wasn't a lack of trust or a lack of hope? And I really felt like the Holy Spirit inspired me and answered that question by saying it was because she ached, the fact that she wasn't with her son. There was an ache in her life. And so she was acting out of the ache of not being with her son anymore. And I was just like, like that transformed how I looked at that mystery, because suddenly I just like felt the ache of a mother who just wants to be with her son. Right. And then I thought about ache of like my own life, and where do I ache for more of Jesus, and how can I like ask Mary to help me in that, to be persistent and looking, right?
Yeah. If you've missed the Eucharist during this time of quarantine and dispensation.
Oh my gosh, that's like, a beautiful one.
What a great way to explore that ache in our heart to return and receive Jesus.
Yes.
Right?
So
what's going on in God the Father during this too?
Yeah.
Like, what is he feeling? What is he thinking? I mean, as much as we can relate to how God feels.
But even just asking perspective, him.
Yeah, asking just him. Ask him. Because one of the things that I came with, where the angst and the sort of the human tension would be, is they realize, sort of like with Gabriel, oh no, it's happening now. Because for them, they realize what's about to happen.
Yeah.
I mean, they were told there's going to be tremendous pain. This is going to pierce your heart.
Right.
And so part of the angst is, oh no, he's my little boy.
Right. Right.
Yeah. I'll try not to cry.
You go on.
I'll try not to cry.
You have freedom.
I have freedom to do that. Yes. So what is in the Father's character? What is in the Father's mission for us? What's in the Father's identity for himself and for us when we really come at the Rosary, you know, through his eyes? Probably the greatest thing of all is it's just love.
Yeah.
Love and mercy, right? Everything the Father has is for us.
Praying through those sorrowful mysteries and getting to God's love in each one of the mysteries.
Wow.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
As each step of Jesus' life plays out through that. Oh.
Right.
And that in God, mercy and justice meet.
Yeah.
Like mercy and justice, you can't separate them in God. Mm-hmm. We tend to see mercy or justice.
Right, right.
And we don't like the idea of a just God. We like the idea of mercy.
Yes.
St. Faustina says, if you don't go through the door of mercy, eventually you're going to go through the door of judgment. Right? So let's go through mercy if we can. But in especially in those mysteries, in the sorrowful mysteries, the way that God's mercy and justice are meeting in the person of Jesus.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And what's going on in his heart is he's not only watching what's happening to God the Son, but he's watching what his other children are doing to God the Son.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Oh my gosh, yeah.
And he's watching how Peter and how Judas, I mean, Judas was one of the guys, right? And God the Father. What is God the Father's feeling towards Judas?
Oh my gosh, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I just love the richness. You'll never end.
Really, truly.
Oh my gosh.
And the Rosary, like we were saying, can be such a gift, because I think about like family stories and how families like to sit around and like reminisce, right? And sharing those stories.
Yeah.
Hey, remember when we walked through this together? Hey, do you remember that moment, that time?
Mm-hmm.
And to think about that gift of journeying with God the Father. It's like you're engaging in the family story all over again, right? It's just a time to reminisce and to be able to enter into deeper relationship, right?
And obviously this can also apply not just to the Rosary, but to our scripture reading and to all of our prayer.
Yep.
It doesn't have to be just this, but this is just kind of what popped at me recently was this idea with the Rosary. And another thing about God that's so important is God is eternal. He is in control. It's his providence. It's his plan. God is never upset in the way that we are, right?
Mm-hmm.
God, I love the image that God is sitting on the throne because he's not standing up, panic, wringing his hands, you know, conducting the orchestra.
Wiping sweat from his brow.
Troop movements.
Trying to pick up the pieces.
Right. Yeah. He's sitting on the throne. And just receiving guests in the throne room, right?
Mm.
I love the image of that. Yeah. He's very much at peace because we believe that God is in control, right?
Yeah.
It's his world. It's his plan, and he's doing it. God is the eternal now.
Mm-hmm. That's great. Amen. That's great.
He is ever-present, and that includes in our lives. And that's what we really learn when we pray through those, is that he's with us every step just as much.
Yeah.
So we'd really challenge you and invite you to take this twist to the rosary. So twist and shout. We'll see you next time on Teachable Tuesdays.
God bless everybody.
Bye.